Hello iPad letterers, it's so nice to see you. My name is Karen, I'm from iPad lettering and I'm here to help you get the most out of your iPad, whether that is with lettering or art or journaling. Today's video is a Procreate tutorial and I'm going to show you how to create beautiful watercolor fruit on your iPad. I'm going to show you how you can paint these fruit pieces all by yourself and how easy it is to achieve that with Procreate. And to help you achieve this a little bit easier, I've created a brand new brush set for Procreate. Now let's jump right into the app and let me show you how to get started. The first thing we are going to do is create a brand new canvas. And for this project, I recommend that you create a canvas that is 2048 pixels wide and 2560 pixels high. And then we're going to tap done and create. And the first thing I want to show you is the new Procreate brushes that I have made for you. The set is called IPL Fruit Painting and it has a set of four painting brushes. It has a watercolor paper background brush and then it has a wide range of different fruit shapes that help you get started with fruit painting really quickly and really easily. The set also comes with a color palette and that palette is called IPL Fruit Platter. It has a selection of colors that really lend themselves for painting fruit. Let's select that great color and let's create a watercolor paper background. We're going to select the IPL watercolor paper grainy brush for this and you can set the brush to 100% and then just paint in the background like this. And then we're going to open up the layers panel and we're going to duplicate this layer twice. And you can see now how the paper becomes quite a bit darker and you can really see the grainy texture come through like this. But we can refine this a little bit. So with the first layer, open up that blend mode and then scroll all the way to the top to set this blend mode to multiply. And then for the second and the third layers, we are going to change the blend mode to color burn. And you can see now how the paper becomes a little bit whiter, but it's still got the beautiful texture and this is exactly what we want. And then we are going to group these layers and we are going to rename the group and call it texture. And the important part here is that textures always have to be above your painting layers. So we're going to create a new layer, but then we're going to drag it below our texture layer. And it's really important to do that because the blend modes mean that the modifications are going to get applied only to the layers that are below the textures. So you can create a few layers here if you would like to do that, just so that you have some spare ones. All right, and then we are going to select one of the templates to start with. And I really like the orange template. So I'm going to select the template. And then you can choose any color. It doesn't matter too much which color you choose. I'm going to select this burnt orange color here and then paint an orange. And you can see here now this creates the outlines of the orange we are going to paint. But this is only going to be used as a template. This will not be visible anymore once we are finished. This is more like a little helper to get you started quickly with painting. Now let's put this in the center of the screen. And then let's decrease the opacity of this layer a little bit so that you can still see the orange shape, but maybe not too much. And then let's create a new layer as well. And now we can paint in the orange. So we're going to start with this middle orange color here. And then we are going to select the watercolor shape brush to start with. This brush here is really, really nice to create a watercolor texture. And what I recommend you do is start painting the orange outline first with sort of a medium pressure. And you don't have to be too precise. You can just paint in the shape like this because you can sort of go around again and maybe even out the parts where you weren't so precise. And then what you want to do as well is you never want to lift the Apple pencil off the screen while you are painting this. So what I'm doing here is filling the shape, but I'm never lifting off the Apple pencil off the screen. And then you can see here where the lines meet, that they connect and they create this beautiful watercolor texture. And then also what you want to do is not be super precise with filling in the shape. So you want to leave a few little gaps. You can see here I'm leaving a few gaps and this creates a really, really nice texture of the orange as well. And then here at the bottom, I don't need any texture. So I'm just going to fill in the whole shape and I can just fill it in like that. And that's the first layer done. And then we're going to paint the leaves and for that we're going to change it to a green color. So depending on the type of leaf you want to paint, you can choose any of the green colors. I'm going to choose the most dark green color here. And then we're going to do the exact same thing. So we're just going to create the outline of the leaf here. And then again in the middle, it's going to be really nice to just leave a little gap here. And then maybe here as well. like this. And then we're going to create the second leaf here as well. And then changing to that brown color to create that stem. And you might want to decrease that brush size a little bit for this. And again, we're going to create the outline first. Never leave the Apple pencil off the screen. And then we are going to paint in the stem here. And so this is our first layer done. And now, of course, it looks a little bit flat. So we are going to refine this now. And in order to refine our fruit, we're going to change to brush. And we can now select that watercolor accents brush. And the reason why I call it this is because we can use this brush to create not just the highlights, but you can also create some darker spots and some shadows as well. So now we're going to select a slightly darker color of orange to start with. And then we can paint in some shadows here. And you can be quite rough with this. It doesn't have to be too precise. And then we're going to change that color. And we're going to select a yellow color here to paint in some highlights here at the top as well. You could also use white for this as well. This can look quite nice as well. White is going to be quite intense. And you can see I'm just putting some color on the page right now. But now what we're going to do is select that smudging tool. And we're going to use the IPL watercolor blend brush with that smudging tool. And now we can smudge this out and create a watercolor look. That smudging tool is pressure sensitive. So the more pressure you put on the Apple pencil, the wider the color spreads on the page. So I recommend that you don't put too much pressure on. And then the size of the brush, I've got it set to around 7%. So you don't want it to be too big so that you can control that smudging a little bit better. And so now it's just going to blend these colors together. And then I also recommend that you avoid the spots here that we left blank, because otherwise you'll lose that nice texture that that brush has created. And so now we are going to smudge this out. I'm going to go all the way around. And you can see now how this creates these really beautiful watercolor textures here. If you find that blending a little bit too intense or maybe not intense enough, definitely feel free to change the opacity of the brush as well. I've got it set to around about 75%, but definitely feel free to change this as well to suit your needs. The more opaque that brush is, the more intense the blending will be. If you find the blending effect too strong, then definitely decrease the opacity here a little bit too. Make it a little bit more subtle. All right, and then we're going to do the same thing with the leaves. So we're going to select some different greens here as well. And again, use the accents brush to paint in the green highlights. Maybe at the tip of the leaf, it can be a little bit lighter. And then sort of towards the end of the leaf, it can be a little bit darker. And at the start, I'm just going to really paint in this color quite rough. Just sort of put it on the page. And then select that dark color here and add some more darkness towards the end of the leaf here. And then we're going to switch back to the smudging tool. And then we're just going to blend this into the page like this to create this beautiful watercolor effect with the colors flowing into each other. And then here at the tip, I'm really decreasing the size of my brush so I can be a little bit more precise with painting in these colors. And again, I'm preserving these parts here where I've left it white because I really like the effect that they create. So if you're smudging over this, then you would lose the effect. So I recommend that you avoid these areas and keep these little white parts here. All right, and then we are also going to blend the colors here where the leaf and the branch meet. And it's always nice to have these colors blend into each other and not make them stop abruptly like they are here. If you were going to paint this with real watercolor, the colors would flow into each other as well. And so I always like to emulate that effect. And then the same here where the branch goes into the orange, we're going to do the same thing. I'm just going to smudge this out to create this watercolor effect. All right, so now this looks pretty good already, but now I want to show you a special trick of how you can make this pop even more. So now we are going to create a new layer, and then we're going to change the blend mode to overlay, and then we're going to select that black color, and now we can select that blending brush, and now we can darken up certain parts of that painting a little bit more. So now the brush size for this is probably going to be around 8%, and now we can paint in some of these dark areas and really make that painting pop a little bit more. It's especially nice if you paint the edges with that dark color to bring up the contrast between the light and the dark areas more. We're going to do the same with the leaf And you can see now how this really has added a lot of dimension to our painting. So now let's turn this off and let me show the difference. So now this was before and after, and this has really added a nice contrast. Now we can refine this a little bit more as well. So you can switch back to the smudging tool and still on the same overlay layer. Now we can smudge this out a bit more and refine the areas of the dark a little bit more. Just want to make this a little bit thinner. And here as well, I feel that's a bit too much. We can just smudge this out so that it's not too dark. All right, and then we are also going to add a shadow here at the bottom of the orange. So now I'm going to add another new layer, and then with that gray color and with that watercolor accent brush, I'm going to paint in that shadow here. And for this, I recommend that you increase the brush size a little bit. Got it set to around about 35% now. And then the nice thing about this brush is that it's really pressure sensitive. So when you first start painting, it puts quite a lot of color on your paper, but then you can decrease the pressure ever so slightly, and then it doesn't put so much color on the page, and it just creates a really, really nice watery effect here. So now this looks pretty cool. And now we can use the smudging tool again to decrease the opacity a little bit and smudge this out. I'm gonna make the size of the brush a little bit bigger, around about 17% is what I have right now. And you can see also that I haven't made the shadow too intense. I always feel that less is more when it comes to shadow, so this is quite a light shadow. And now what we can do is change the size of it a little bit as well, maybe make it a bit more narrow, so it gives it a more of a 3D effect where the shadow actually hits the ground. And I think this looks pretty good. So now the last thing we want to do is add some splatters. This is optional, of course. I like adding some splatters, and I've also made a splatter brush for you. So we're going to create another new layer, and we're going to change that brush to that watercolor splatters brush. And then we're going to use that orange color here, and we can just add some random splatters. And you see here the brush creates these really cool splatters, and they are really random. So sometimes it creates splatters and sometimes it doesn't, but this is random. And of course this is on purpose because you don't want it to be too even. And then also when it comes to splatters, I always think less is more as well. So I feel I've added too many splatters here, but luckily we have the two-finger tap undo of Procreate, so we can undo this and then we'll do it again. And interestingly, I actually spent quite a lot of time creating these splatters, so maybe they're not as random as it seems, but I really think they make a difference. And so spending a little bit of time getting your splatters right can make a big difference to your artwork. Of course, there's a lot more different fruit pieces that I've included in that brush pack. There is 30 different pieces of fruit for you to choose from and to practice your watercolor painting. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Give me a thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And then I'm also going to loop up another video with another watercolor painting tutorial, so you can keep watching and you can keep learning about how to create beautiful watercolor pieces on your iPad. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.